Good afternoon, dear fourth class students. I hope you all are fine. From today, I'm going to start the reading of first chapter of Wizard book. The first chapter name is Don Quixote and the Windmill. How will we pronounce this word? Don Quixote and the Windmills. This chapter is written by Miguel de Cervantes. Okay? This chapter is written by Miguel de Cervantes. He was a very famous Spanish writer. Here are written about him. One second. Yes, this is the name of the author, Miguel de Cervantes. He was a Spanish writer, means he belongs to the Spain, novelist, poet, playwright. He was widely regarded as the greatest writer in the Spanish language and one of the world's preeminent novelists. His best known work is Don Quixote and the Windmill. This is an adventureful story and it has mainly two characters. One is Don Quixote and second one his friend, assistant Sancho Panza. Okay, what is his name? Sancho Panza. Now let us read the story. Before starting this story, there is given a warm-up page. In this page, you are planning to explore a forest. Means you are planning to visit a forest. Name one friend you would like to take with you. And there are given 8 objects below. Choose any 4 which you would like to take with you during the adventure. Okay, this is the activity and you will write it yourself, your name, your adventure buddy, means your friend whom you like to take with you on this adventurous trip. Things we will take with us on the trip, means the 8 objects are given here. Choose any 4. Now let's start the story. Before starting, there are given few word meanings. Don Quixote, it is the pronunciation, say like Don Quixote. Knights means specially trained soldiers of high rank. Set off. The next word is set off. Set off means to begin a journey. Sancho Panza, the name of the assistant. Squire. Squire means an assistant to knight. Assistant means helper. Back down means give up. Back down means give up. And the last, windmills. Windmills, the building or structure with large blades on the outside that moves when turned by force of wind. Earlier, windmills had sails in the place of blade. And windmills are usually used to produce electricity. Okay? Milestones means large flat stone used to crush grain to make flour. The last word is here, lens. Lens means a weapon with long wooden handle and a pointed metal end that are used by people fighting on horse in the pastime. Bhala, jisko hum bolte na, us bhala bhi bolte hain same. Next, adventures means accidents, the happenings. Now, let's start the reading of this chapter. The first come back on page number 5. In the text that we are about to read, the central character Don Quixote. Don Quixote. Here Don Quixote imagines that he is one of the brave knights that we read about in the stories. He acts like a brave man and dreams of having adventures. His imagination makes him find adventure when there is no adventure at all. This leads to funny situations. Now listen, dear students, carefully. This story is related to a man who lived in a village and the village name is La Mancha. This village is in the Spain. And there lived a man who loved to read books about knights. Knights kaun hote hain? Yodha, mahan, bahadur log. And he loves to read about the knights. Now first scene is there. One day, Don Quixote decided to set off in the search of adventure, but first he went off to talk to Sancho Panza. Sancho was a foolish man who lived with his wife and children. Now here is a conversation between Don Quixote and Sancho Panza. Don Quixote said, Sancho Panza, get ready. I need a squire to share my adventures who help me on the journey. Will you go with me? After hearing the words of Don Quixote, Sancho Panza replied, But sir, I am only a poor laborer, and how can I leave my family behind? The next scene. Don Quixote was not one to back down. Back down means to give up. He was not one of them who gave up very earlier. He replied, We will defeat many knights, gather many rich sand, conquer many kingdoms. In return for your services, I will make you the governor of an island. Just think how grand that would be. At this, Sancho Panza replied, If your honor will promise me this, I'll gladly serve you. Dear students, one day when Don Quixote decided to start his journey in the search of adventure, he met with a person named Sancho Panza and offered him to be his assistant. But Sancho said that I have a poor family, I have two children and my wife, I can't live without them, I can't leave them alone. Okay, and in this next scene, he told him that we both together will defeat many brave warriors and gather kingdoms or money. I will make you the governor of an island if you agree to come with me. The other man, Sancho, he agreed to move with him. Okay, now move on to the next page. Now that Don Quixote had a squire, squire means now he had an assistant, nothing could stop him from having grand adventure. But there was a problem. There was a small problem. What was that? Let's read more to find out the problem. Here Sancho Panza replied, Sir, I cannot run very fast and I have no horse to ride upon. May I follow you on my donkey? Now, here Sancho Panza is asking that may he follow him on the donkey? At this, Don Quixote replied, None of my books tells me that squire ride donkeys, but yes, you may bring the animal along. Once we find a disrespectful knight, we shall defeat them and take his horse. Until then, you can ride this donkey. Don Quixote agreed and said that I never heard or read about a knight who ride on donkey, but it's okay. You may ride on it until you got a horse by defeating any other knight. Now, let's move on the next scene. Now, one evening, they both have planned to set out for an adventure. And here, one evening, Don Quixote and Sancho Panza set out. Set out means started their journey, ready for the excitement of adventure. Suddenly, what happened? Don Quixote said, Look over there, my friend. There are at least 30 great giants standing there. I shall fight and defeat them all. Dear students, here you can see these are the windmills. And Don Quixote looked at them and said they are the great giants. He imagined that they are the giants and they are standing there. We shall go and defeat them all. At this, Sancho Panza, this person replied, What giants, sir? Because he was not able to see any giants there. He was looking there that the windmills are there, but his imagination power make them giants. At this, Sancho Panza was confused. What giants, sir? Now move on to the next page. Over there, waving their long arms at us, Don Quixote again pointed that, Look over there, my friends. These are the giants. They are standing. They are waving their long arms at us. At this, Sancho Panza got confused and he said, "Please look again, sir. Those are not giants. They are the windmills. What you call their arms are really their sails. They move round and round in the wind to make the millstone turn." Okay. In this scene, Sancho Panza, his assistant, he tried to make him understand that they are not giants. They are the windmills. But he is not listening. Now move on the next. But Don Quixote did not listen because he was not ready to listen. He was sure that windmills were giants. He prepared to attack them. Now, when Sancho Panza tried his best to make him understand that they are not the giants, they are the windmills, but he was not in mood to listen him, and he said, "It is quite clear to me that you know nothing about the adventure." Don Quixote got angry and he said, "Ki, you know nothing about the adventure. I will tell you. Don't worry. They are the giants. If you are afraid, then you can stay here. I shall go forward and fight the battle." Battle means the war. Now, he make the Sancho Panza to stay here. "I will go myself and defeat them all." Okay? Sancho Panza. Now, come on to the last page of this chapter. No, second last page. As he raised his horse forward, the wind rose and sail began to move very fast. "Do not run away from me, cowards. There is only one knight here. Yet he is brave enough to attack you all. Move your arms as much as you like. You will not stop me." In this scene, Don Quixote was getting angry by looking at the giants, and he is warning them, "Stay there, I am coming to defeat you." Now next, what happened? When he struck the moving sail, Don Quixote's lance means his weapon, which he is carrying in his hands, broke, wo toot gaya, and he was thrown off his horse, aur wo apne horse se bhi niche gir gaya. At this, Sancho Panza come there hurriedly and said, sir, are you okay?" At this, he replied, "Ah," ki means usko pain thi, and he was crying in pain. "Ah." Now, the last page, Sancho Panza hoped that Don Quixote would have learned a lesson from the fall. At this, Sancho said, "Oh, sir, didn't I warn you that they are the only windmills?" Don Quixote said, "Be quiet, Sancho. I think that a magician turned those giants into windmills so that I would not be able to conquer them." Conquer means hota hai, overcome or take control by military force. Means recognize them. "But in the end, with my good sword, I shall win." Okay, so this is the story of Don Quixote. He imagined himself as a brave knight and tried to defeat, and everywhere, wherever he looked, he looked like a adventure. Or at this, Sancho Panza said, "I hope so." Sancho realized his mistake, that nothing could be done about his silly master, and so they set off once again in the search of other misadventure. So in this story, we have learned about Don Quixote, a man who believed himself a knight, who believed himself a brave warrior. Okay, and we got a message by reading this chapter, that men are able to create a reality of their own, and it can affect others as well as themselves. Okay, so this is the story. Now read this story once again. Thank you.